What is up, guys? We are at Harry Grove Stadium, which is home of a very interesting team name called the Spire City Ghost Hounds. This is also home of the Frederick Keys, who are an MLB draft league team. So the Frederick Keys used to be affiliated with the Baltimore Orioles for a very, very long time. I was here when they were affiliated with the Baltimore Orioles. And now they're an independent league team. And they are playing the Long Island Ducks, which have Wilson Ramos, Brian Goodwin, Alejandro Diaz. I mean, the team is absolutely loaded with former MLB players, as well as the Spire City Ghost Hounds, because they got guys like Starlin Castro on the team. They got former Potomac National players, which I've seen, Jose Marmolejos, Oswaldo Abreu. Very, very interesting players on this team, both very loaded. I'm currently walking around the outside part of the stadium just because it's quieter and I don't want to get around the music. I'll be hopefully having a very solid autograph day. That's the only reason I was here for. It was an hour and 40 minute drive for only 50 miles. Now, of course, if you live in LA, that's nothing. Whatever. But for me, that's a very, very long and annoying drive. So, hoping to get some good autographs, get some good footage of a stadium, which I have not recorded at yet, which is also really, really cool. And see what footage we get. Because I have to vlog this game, because other than that, it'd feel kind of pointless if I came here and did absolutely nothing video-wise. So, we'll see how it goes. There is a handful of balls that are by the wall, which I kind of want to pick up, but at the same time, I'm not sure how much I'm allowed to be out here, to be perfectly honest, because there's probably tons of balls out here, but for the time being, we're just going to walk around the stadium, just pretend like we're videoing, don't care about anything else, and hope you guys enjoyed the video. Let's get a little view of batting practice here. That's Alex Dickerson in the box. I remember how he bats. Got the Long Island Ducks in the field right now. This is the lefty group right now. Also, I did pick up two balls as I was walking by in the outfield, but I tossed them both back. Al Albert. As I was watching batting practice from the corner, Alex Dickerson hit a ball that I was like, I have no idea where it was going. It hit the scoreboard. I'll show you what it looks like from inside. But he hit the scoreboard right above where it says Ghost Hounds. I think it'll pop up on camera. Right above there. He hit a ball that hit off the scoreboard. That is at least another 30 feet away from the wall. This is like right center field. And hit the scoreboard. That's absolutely absurd. So, autograph wise is done for the first half of the game. I didn't do as great as I like. Dickerson signed 04. Lou Ford signed his 3. Goodwin was very nice and signed 2. Didn't try for Tejada. Diaz walked by. Brady. Got Boo Pal. Not the Orioles Boo Pal. Another Boo Pal. Got him to sign all four of his. He was nice. Steven Brault was a very nice guy and signed his too. And then I got Roddy Reed to sign his spring training locker room tag. And he gave it a really nice signature too. He did question me if it was real or not because he thought it looked too clean. But it has the sticker on it. So whether or not MLB, whether or not it's a real one, but Roddy questioned it. But not too bad. I just hope the game goes by quickly so I can get a few more guys after the game. And the Ducks are out to a quick 2-0 lead, still with no outs on the first. Here's a familiar guy. Oh, right field. Gotta be on it. End of inning. Yep. And now they just rung up Roddy Reed because he wasn't set at the 8-second mark. Oh my. These umpires are being very time sensitive right now. I think third base coach is about to go bye-bye.
So Jeff is now on the first base concourse. It's time for Nimio. Jeff, what do you got?
Is he gonna yank him? Is he gonna yank him? There you go. He's taking Roddy Reed back because they need the catcher back. It's been a very entertaining but very slow first inning. So, I was hoping for a fast game. We're still in the top of the fourth. And it's been an hour and 30 minutes. We're not even halfway through yet. It's been an hour and 30 minutes. We're the But both pitchers are kind of slow, and also the score is currently 7-5 for Long Island. So it's been a shootout, kind of what I thought it was going to be. And the Ghost Hounds have just changed their pitcher. He did not make it through four innings. And there's also a runner on second base with no outs in the top four. I'm genuinely thinking about leaving early, which I don't normally do. But it takes an hour to get back home. And it's just been kind of boring, though. Very quiet crowd. There's not really anybody here. There's maybe like 200 people. But yeah, we'll see. And here's Alex Dickerson. Who's the one who hit the ball? Right, actually, right above where his name is. To give perspective, it's 325. That ball went right over his head. It's 325 down to right field. It's 400 to center field. So it's probably about 370 just to get it over that front wall. Get it over the two higher ones, 400 with the three in front. That's probably, estimation-wise, a little bit over a 450-foot home run they hit during batting practice, which is absolutely ridiculous. I mean, he's batting 348 with 16 home runs and 58 RBIs. Like, he's having a really solid year. I don't know why an MLB team will not pick him up.
And
that towel is just like that, we have a tie game in the fifth at 9-9. So here's a bit of a difference in Frederick than Bowie. Now, of course, in Bowie, they have grass as well, but you can't stand on it. Here in Frederick, you actually can. As you can see, there's other people over there as well. But yeah, you can stand right down, right on the fence line. You got the bullpens right there. They have those a little bit far back, but yeah. Very nice little addition that Frederick has to make it a little bit more kid-friendly than Bowie is. But if you guys see, like, everything about the stadium, like, from this side, it looks exactly like Bowie. It's the same exact one. Go watch the Bowie BayHawks vlogs. It's the same exact setup, same exact seating, same exact bleachers, like, same exact stand, same exact friend area over there. Carousel, same thing at Bowie. They also have a carousel. They have a giant air slide. In, here in Frederick, though. They just changed pitchers. Ball low. 9-9. Has immediately come in through three balls in a row with runners on second and third. Although loading the bases wouldn't be a bad move right here. And they will be loaded. Bases loaded. They need one out to get out of the inning to keep it tied at 9-9 here in the fifth inning. It's the fifth inning, and it's 9-10. This game's been going for 2 hours. Unbelievable. Well, there it goes. Up until that point, each team had 9 runs, 12 hits, and 1 error. This game is unbelievable. I have not seen a high-scoring game like this, and as even as it has been. This game is unbelievable.
I'm right behind the speaker, so I'm not even sure how well you can hear me. I just got a Wilson Ramos-style ball, which was really, really cool. Well, ball bounced down the hallway, right around over here. I thought I almost had to beat on it to catch it, but the ball spun way too much. It was still like another 3-4 feet away from catching it. I ran down, got it. A whole bunch of kids went running farther down. They didn't know where the ball went. And there was one little girl who was just standing there, probably about 7 or 8, just standing there. And I asked her if she had a ball. She didn't. So I decided to give it away, even though I did really want to keep that one, too, because it's Ramos. That's really, really cool. She was really nice about it, which is nice to see. I enjoy giving balls away, and kids actually, like, really appreciating it, which is really nice. There's so many kids that, like, don't really deserve one because they get the ball, they don't say thank you or anything. I'm a big, big person for please and thank you. If you say please and thank you, I'll most definitely give you a ball, that's for sure. Up the middle. Another run scores. It is now 11-9, Ducks. Just a little update, because this game has just been an eternity at this point. It is the top of the 8th. It is 12-9, Ducks. They still got runners in the corners. At this point, and it's past 10 o'clock. It's been an over 3-hour long game, and we're in the top of the 8th inning. Just let this game end.